Here in Gulu City, images have been circulating on social media showing the extent of the destruction and damage that has been caused by violence in the contested upper land.
The photos show several burnt grass-thatched houses, motorcycles, household properties, and injured persons. This morning, the Amuru Resident District Commissioner confirmed the arrest of three ringleaders. The violence is suspected to be fueled by a section of leaders from Adjumani District.
In Adjumani, by yesterday, we had already arrested three of the ringleaders. I expect the arrest is continuing. The district forest officer, the environment officers have all been summoned because they were the one behind the arrangement, the organization to do what they termed as a country walk. But the country walk turned criminal. You riot, the anti-riot police is there. And so whoever leads the population into a state of riot should be prepared to answer the legal consequences of why you lead people into a destruction.
The arrests follow an outburst by local council leaders from Amuru District who believe that actually people in Apar are being unfairly targeted.
President know this thing very well, is a problem and to the solution. So we must request President Yoweri Museveni to come out clearly to support, to let the people of Apar be free.
The people kill are the people between 20 to 30 years. So since the elders gave their position, they failed to listen. The young people are saying 72 hours without which we shall act.
In 2018, President Yoweri Museveni directed for any evictions in Apar to stop. He later appointed a committee chaired by the former Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya, to help ceasefire between the Madi and the Acholi people.
So the issue is one that is the government that has required the law in our hand. We feel betrayed to the maximum, to the point that we feel people of Adjumani or people of Madi should not cross even on our land.
So far, 20, I confirm, not yesterday, not the incident of yesterday, started way back 2015. So, 20. So, yesterday attacked, 20 people were injured.
Human rights defenders believe it is the right time for the government to step in and settle the conflict in Apar.
And these young people are capable of doing anything. But it is not yet too late. Together with the young people, the government can move down to sort out this issue.
We want to caution the leaders in all the districts, both in Acholi and in Madi, there are particular leaders who seems to be motivating people to take actions other than legal actions. Their days are numbered because we are zeroing down on them. If it means we should take the routes to get a solution, we'll pick the routes.
The Apar land is estimated to be 40 square kilometers, and in 2017 it was declared to be part of Adjumani district by the Minister of Local Government, Tom Butime.
28,000 people are currently estimated to be staying in the contested Apar land. The ethnic violence has been ongoing since 2011. Joseph Omagoro, reporting for the news in Gulu City.
The Apar land is estimated to be 40 square kilometers. In 2017, it was declared to be part of Adjumani district by the Minister of Local Government, Tom Butime.